All right. So it seems like where I left off, based off of my comments here, I was in the middle of programming, first serializing, then sending the event VoIPs. So the thing with that is that there's a specification that I as noted by this document. Right here. So I need to get the object UID and the event operation and parameter. I also, if I remember correctly, only have, what, 42? Of them that I can fit in a single in a single message. I don't know, there's something about using a vector on a non-pointer type that has me a little on edge. You know what? I'd feel better if this was a pointer type. Because at least then I know how it works. Let me double check that that's the right thing. Push back. Add an element to the back. All right. So we want the object UID, which, if I remember correctly, is just objects list dot at I point, and what we want is get variables. Get UID dot get value. This should shift it over by 24 bytes. And we want to modulo by 256. If I remember, this is what you do to get the UID. I'm going to double check though. Think I get the I set the ID somewhere down here. Okay, yeah, we just set the variable UID. I suppose it's fair. Right, then the next two operation or the next two bytes have to be decoded. It's not as easy as a switch statement since C++ does not offer switch statements for strings. Though, since there's not too many values. I think I can just put up with it. If I remember correctly, this is the this is, these are the values. Time to do something like this again. Actually, this is wrong. We need this to be events. Well, otherwise, this should be solid. What did I set them to? Or what were the Expose for value 1, open for value 2, and unlock for value 3. Simple enough. Dang it, what was the other? All right. Open and unlock. Should be good. Of course, seems like we have a bunch of errors here. All right. Gonna put this over here. And this up. All right. In this source file, which I'm assuming is this one, because this is the only one that has info.back. On line 29. Which, might I say, this is not the same line as here. Object list, standard vector, runtime objects, get variables, does not have a class type. I screwed up somewhere, didn't I? That should do that. All right. Expected closing bracket before bracket in a different thing. All right. I suppose that's fair. It looks like it would give an error. And this is. This should be right here. Okay. Seems like it's good. But in any case, we have to implement sending logic. This is nice and all, but we ought to do something with it. So, for went, actually we want event 8_t. This is to keep how many we have packed in the current message. So, actually, do we already have this? Okay, yeah, we already have this. Then Okay. Okay, it gives undefined reference errors, but that's to be expected. So what we want to do here is we want to take all the information from the small buffer, or set a small buffer in info, and we want to put that into the thing. So I could put this right here. Then let's see. It should really only be equal to 42, but because if it's greater than 42, then it's written somewhere it really shouldn't. I see a problem. You know what I think I could do? I think I could store this message. So I'm gonna try that. I want to double check that that is okay. There's already some errors, but UINT 16B. Remember to stay hydrated. In case char buffer UINT 16ID. Yeah, this makes sense. I'm going to use ID 999 for messages to be sent. Actually, what is this? Or other messages. All right. Hold up. All right. Receive stuff. Auto zero buffer or UINT. UINT 8 I equals 0 I is less than I plus plus. U16 on ID. Alright, so the message that is checked at this point. So yeah, I should store the other messages. Actually, one thing I should do is separate messages that have an ID from messages that don't when you're not checking for an ID. First, use ID. And I'm going to copy paste this over here. But I'm going to modify it because I want this to make sure it doesn't use an ID. And then this won't care. Store message was not declared within this scope. Of course it wasn't. I did not include its header. All right, hold on. Wait a minute, was that hexadecimal or? Okay, so. One eight F divided by 6 bytes. Okay, yeah, that was hexadecimal. In any case, this also needs to have. Is the packet ID? 0E. And I need auto footer as well. Gonna double check that that's how it works. No, it's net helper. Auto header. Check header, auto footer checks. Why did I name it that? Also missing semicolon. Going to need this down here as well. I think this is good. Right, where are these errors? Where are these errors? Where do they be? It's this file. Okay, 8027 expected ending bracket before semicolon, or I said, I guess, ending parenthesis. And this was right, 80, line 80. Fair enough. That was a pretty stupid mistake that I made. Okay, hold on. We have a lot of errors that are all the same. And I'm guessing because they're right next to each other, it's this batch. 82, 84, 86, 88, 90, and 92. Yep, I can see the error. Lines up very nicely. Alright, is that everything for that? I think that's everything for that. Now, of course, I'm going to have to send this at some point. Probably should make sure that the character is not local. I'm gonna do this. I'm going to do the same thing for this piece of code down here. That's going to give an error almost immediately, and I'm going to put something up here to prevent it from keeping compiling, or from compiling every time. Okay, it seems concerned with these errors first. I suppose it's valid. Close off this get message, and we want this particular flavor of get message. Is that correct? Send message. Yeah. Though I'm still getting some errors. Get message was not declared in this scope, probably because I didn't include its header. I did not include its header. This is actually like two headers I need to include. Since these should already be valid messages. I shouldn't have to worry about like doing auto footer checks or auto header checks or anything like that. Does this compile? No. It does not. It does not like me. Okay. What's the first error? Error, expected ending bracket before 4. Fair enough. I got rid of that one. Invalid conversion from UINT16T to char on line 23. Okay, I suppose that's also correct. This is out of order. All right, and the only error left is new delete, which new delete is not even syntactically valid or even sensical in any case. And it's the one thing I used as a compile prevention. So, I guess we're good. All right, for UINT16, and this just goes ahead and iterates through all messages that have a ID of 999. That way, when I want to send a bunch of messages, but I don't have the thing for it, I can just store it with this, and it will send up to 8. Maybe I should increase that to like 16. I don't know. All right, but there is still one more thing. And it is heard, not seen. C++ net helper h C++ post office.h. So what I want to do here is I want to go ahead and get all the sounds and to put them into packets. Since there's generally going to be one sound, I typically don't have to worry about sending multiple packets, but then again, there shouldn't be 66 event VoIPs either, but yet I still split that when necessary. This one should be slightly easier because I just need to pull a string out of something and put it into a different thing. Like code. Sound VoIPs. Sound. That's all I need is sound. Everything else is handled by mutual. So now I have an if. First, I need to set this up properly. What object do I want? It's this one. Actually, I'm just going to yoink that and place it here. Alright, and they can be a total of 30 hex, or hex 30 bytes long. And what I want to do here is I need to copy out of and then into. That didn't give me any errors because it's still technically valid, despite the fact that's not what I want to do with that. Right, net helper and copy string will put a string into, extract string is what I want, but also copy string. So, I wonder. Okay, first, I'm also going to do a calculation. So 30 bytes long. Well, x 30 bytes long, and we have 189 or 180f divided by 30 bytes, and we can store 8. What if I did 9 bytes? 10 bytes? 9 bytes. Wait. Okay, that's, yeah, 1 8f divided by 30. 18F divided by 31. Oh, neat. All right. I'm going to store another bit of information. And this bit of information is going to usually be default. I'm going to modify this, however. This. Should probably have that there already, but there we go. Wait, no, I don't need to extract. I need to copy. Sorry. I'm going to use this. Hold on, I'm thinking about one thing. So I'm probably going to have 127 as 1. So I'll take the pitch, multiply it by 127, and we'll have that. Then we'll see. All right, I suppose that's fine. Then I have to put this in. I'm gonna look up the function copy stream buffer, un16 or std string, and un16 max. All right. I believe that is correct. Then right here, I need, do I have a simple copy thing? I okay, so here we have a signature for something to copy from one buffer to another. So it's between extract string and auto zero. I know it doesn't matter, but I want to maintain consistency. I think that's good. Give me a moment. Sorry about that. In any case, so now we have a function to copy stuff over. Probably wasn't all that necessary to define here, but it would probably be useful for some other case. And I would like to have it handy. And just before I do anything else, sorry, need to take this, divide it by, or multiply it by 127. And that will be the resolution of pitch shifting. With that, I think we're all ready to go. Except for a little bit that I have to do here. Wait, hold on. How does this work over here? Oh, I actually have all of this copied in. Okay. Well, I could probably change that up since I have this. Actually, that's if that's why I made it. Only if I could remember what I named it. Ah, yes, copy buffer. Ooh. All right. So we have a source. And a destination. You know what? That's going to be it for today. I'm going to fix these errors probably tomorrow. But that's going to be it for today. If you were watching the stream, thank you. If you are watching later on YouTube, thank you. It's going to be it for me. So until I see you again, this is goodbye.